So today we are going to learn divisibility tests for 2 to 11 by an handmade website which is made by me. It is made by me. You can also see the code. Let us show you the code. Okay, it's a handmade website. I am made it by my hands. Let I open for you. Sorry. Okay, so this is the code which you can see. Okay. This is the code. Okay. And when I run this code, I get this website. Okay. So let's get started. Before understanding the rules of divisibility tests, first we have to understand what are divisibility tests actually. See, divisibility tests are those which are used to check that a number is divisible by another number or not in a fast way. Means like you are given any number, like you are given 12 and you are say that only check that is 12 is divisible by 2 or not. So what you will do? You will first divide, and if the remainder is 0, then you will say that it's divisible by 2. So it will take a lot of time. So instead that, you can apply the divisibility test for 2. Let's look at it. Okay, what's the divisibility test of 2? If the number is even, okay, what is an even number? I.e. it is, if it is ending with 2, 4, 6, 8 or 0, then it's divisible by 2. Means if a number is ending with 2, 4, 6, 8 or 0, then it's divisible by 2. Here you can see the example, like 72 is divisible by 2. Because 72 is even. Why it's even? Because it is ending with 2. Okay. And 2 is an even number. That's why 72 is also a even number. Now let's check the divisibility test for 3. Okay, if the sum of the digits of the number is divisible by 3, then the whole number is divisible by 3. What is the meaning of this? Okay, like you have a number AB, like you have a number suppose AB, then you then what you have to do, you have to do A plus B. Okay, means their digits are A and B. So you have to do the sum of that, A plus B. And if the answer is divisible by 3, then the whole number AB is divisible by 3. Okay, let's see an example. Like see here, 72 is divisible by 3. Because sum of their digits is equals to 7 plus 2. 72 is equal to 7 plus 2, means sum of their digits. And 7 plus 2 is equal to 9. And if we divide it with 3, we get 3. Means it's divisible by 3. Okay, the 72 is divisible by 3. Okay. Now let's see the divisibility test for 4. Okay. If the number formed by the last two digits of the main number is divisible by 4, then the whole number is divisible by 4. What is the meaning of that? Okay, like there is a number ABCD. So what you have to do, you have to separate two digits from the right. Okay, now the number will be CD. So now you have to check that CD is divisible by 4. If it is divisible by 4, then the whole number ABCD is divisible by 4. If it is not divisible by 4, then ABCD will also not divisible by 4. Okay, now let's check an example to understand it in a better way. Like here you are saying, seeing 412. Okay, 412 is divisible by 4. Okay, why it's divisible by 4. See, if we separate the last two digits of the number from the right, okay, we get 12. Okay, means here also it's the same thing is written, because it's last two digits, i.e. 12. Okay, 12 is divisible by 4. That's why the whole number 412 is divisible by 4. Now let's read the divisibility test for 5. Divisibility test for 5 is very easy, just like its table. Okay, if the number is ending with 0 or 5, then the number is divisible by 5. Okay, in 5 table, you are only seeing the numbers which are ending with 0 or 5, like 5 1 is 5, 5 2 is 10, 5 3 is 15, 5 4 is 20, and so on. So here you are noticing only 0, only numbers ending with 0 or 5. You are not observing that the number is ending with any other number, means you are not noticing. Okay, so we can make a rule that if the number is ending with 0 or 5, then the number is divisible by 5. Example, see, 15 is divisible by 5 because it's ending with 5. Okay, 15 is divisible by 5 because it's ending by 5. Okay, you can see it's ending with 5. Now let's see the divisibility test for 6. Okay, it's very easy. Okay, if the number is divisible by both 2 and 3, then it's also divisible by 6. Means if the number is divisible by 2 also and 3 also, then it's also divisible by 6. Okay, now let's again check the divisibility test for 2 and 3. Okay, what was the divisibility test for 2? Divisibility test for 2 was that if the number is ending, means if the number is ending with 2, 4, 6, 8 or 0, i.e. it's even, if it's even, i.e. ending with 2, 4, 6, 8 or 0, then it's only divisible by 2. And what was the divisibility test for 3? The divisibility test for 3 was if the sum of the digits of the number is divisible by 3, then the whole number is divisible by 3. Means the digits, if the sum of the digits of the number is divisible by 3, then the whole number is divisible by 3. Okay, like now let's see example 12 is divisible by 6. Sorry friends, it's 3. Let's correct it and make it 6. Okay, it's friends. I am just editing. Sorry friends. Okay, and I am. Yes. Now let's run this again. Okay. So it's okay. Got it. Okay. So we'll open it through file manager. Okay. I'll unpin it from taskbar. Okay. Let I open it again. Okay, let I open it. Okay. Now let's see, does it. Okay, now see, 12 is divisible by 6. Why it's divisible by 6? Because it's divisible by both 2 and 3. See, the number is all, see, the number is ending with 2, means it's even, that's why it's divisible by 2. And if we do the sum of the digits of 12, i.e. 1 plus 2, we get 3, and 3 divided by 3 is 1. That's why it's divisible by 3 also. Now let's see the divisibility test for 7. It's a bit complicated, but you will understand it very easily. Okay. It's in very easy language. Very easy language. Okay. See, first, separate the last digits from the other digits of the number from the right. Okay. Then double the last digit and then subtract it from the remaining digits, and if the difference is divisible by 7 or if the difference is 0, then the whole number is divisible by 7. I think you would not understand this. Okay, so what's the meaning of this? Okay, see, first you have to separate the last digit, last one digit of the number, any number, from the right. Okay, not from the left, from the right. Then you have to double that number, means you have to multiply the number with 2. Okay. Then whatever is the answer, you have to minus it from the remaining digits. Okay. And if the remaining digits are smaller than the double of the number, if we will minus, we will got negative number. We don't want negative number. So what we will do, we will minus the remaining digits from the double. Okay, and if the difference is divisible by 7, means it comes in the table of 7, like it's 7, the difference is 7, 14, 21, 28, or so on. Okay, or if the difference is 0, then it's divisible by 7. Okay, now let's see example 1, 14. Okay, let's say the example of 14. Now see, if we separate one digit from the right, so we get 4. Okay, so if we multiply the 4 from 2, means if we double 4, so we get 8. Okay, now see friends, we can't minus the double from the remaining digits, because see, the remaining digit is only 1, means it's 1. Okay, and a double is greater than 1, it's 8. Okay, so if we will minus it, we will get answer in negative number. So we don't want the answer in negative number. So what we will do, we will minus 1 from it. Okay, so see, if we minus 8, 1 from 8, we got 7. And the difference is 7. Okay, it's divisible by 7. If you divide 7 by 7, so you will get 1. Okay, with no remainder. Now I think it's easy for you. Okay, now let's get in the divisibility test for 8. It's a bit like 4 only. Okay, if the number formed by the last 3 digits of the main number is divisible by 8 and the whole number is divisible by 8. What's the meaning of this sentence? If means, like, see, in the divisibility test of 2, what we revise, that if the number formed by the last 2 digits from the right of the main number is divisible by 4. Means last 2 digits from the right. Then what we focus? We focus in last 2 digits on the right. But here we have to focus on last 3 digits on the right. Okay. Okay, now you would understand the divisibility test for 8. Now let's see the example. Okay. Example is 4888. Means 4888 is divisible by 8. Because why it's divisible by 8? Because if you separate the last 3 digits of the main number, means of the 4888, from the right, you will get 888 or 888 or 888. Okay. So if you will divide the 888 from 8, you will get 111, means 111. With no remainder. Okay, that's why it's 4888 is divisible by 8. Now let's see the divisibility test for 9. See, divisibility test for 9 is like divisibility test for 3 only. In divisibility test for 3, what we have learned, that if the sum of the digits of the number is divisible by 3, then the number is divisible by 3. Now here what is the new thing, that if the if the sum of the digits of the number is divisible by 9, okay, not by 3, if it's divisible by 9, then the whole number is divisible by 9. Let's see an example. See, here 99 is divisible by 9 because, see, if you will add the digits of the number, means the digits are 2 times 9, so you have to add 9 plus 9, okay, then 9 plus 9 is 18. Then if we divide 18 from, if we divide 9 from 18, we get 2, okay. Okay, so like this was the divisibility test of for 9. Now let's see the divisibility test for 10. It's so easy, it's easy from 5 also, friends. It's very easy, very easy. If the number is ending with 0, then it's divisible by 0. Means if the number is ending with 0, then only if the number will be divisible by 10. Like, okay, example, let's say an example, 340. Okay, 340 is divisible by 10. Why? Because it's ending with 0. Okay, that's why it's divisible by 10. And did you know how many times it's divisible by 10? 34. If you will multiply 10 and 34, you will get 340. Okay, now let's see divisibility. Let's have a look at the divisibility test for 11. It's a bit complicated, like divisibility test for 7. But you will understand it slowly, like divisibility test for 7. Okay. If the in divisibility test for 11, you have to focus on the places of the digits. Okay. Not the place value, but like it's in first place, like second place. Okay. Now see, if the difference between the sum of the digits of the even and all odd places of the number is 0 or a multiple of 11, then the whole number is divisible by 11. Okay, what's the meaning of that? Let I show you by calculating. Okay, let's see by calculating. Let's write a number. Let's understand with our example. Okay. Like here you see a number 2332. Okay, now here you have to find the places which is in even place, the digits which is in even place, and the digits which is in the odd place. Then you have to sum that, and if the difference is 0 or a multiple of 11, then the whole number is divisible by 11. Okay, now see, let's see the the number is of 4 places. Okay, 1 2 3 4. Okay, so what will be the odd places from 1 to 4? 1 and 3. And what will be the even places? 2 and 4. Okay. Okay, so see, in first place 2 is written and in third place 3 is written. Okay, if we plus 2 and 3, we get 5. Okay, then in second place there is 3. And in 4, there is 2. And if we do 3 plus 2, we get 5. And if we minus them, 5 minus 5, we get 0. So, it's divisible by 11. The difference should be either 0 or divisible by 11. Okay. So, see, here example, here the same thing is written. 2332 means 2332 is divisible by 11 because sum of the old odd places digit of the number is 5 and sum of the even place digit of the number is 5 and difference of them is equal to 5 minus 5 is equal to 0. Now let's see, friends. Let me tell you a trick. Okay, See friends, suppose you face na number and you don't know the divisibility rule of that number, and if you are given is this number is divisible by this number, so what you will do? You will get confused. Okay, so there is a trick. Okay, you have to find co-prime number, factors of the number. Okay, means there is a trick for finding co-prime number. If the first trick is the HCF, should if you find the HCF of the factors, they should be one, or they should be one number should be prime and one number should be opposite. Okay, like suppose you not know the divisibility test for 6. Okay, and now you are given that you have to find that 12 is divisible by 6. So what you have to do, you have to find the co-prime factors of 6, that's 2 and 3. Now see friends, here one number is both number are primes. Okay, so they are not co-prime factors. No, they are. How? See, the number, if you will do the HCF of 2 and 3, you will get 1. Okay, that's why there is the rule that if the number is divisible by both 2 and 3, then it's also divisible by 6. Okay, if you are asked why there is only if the number is divisible by both 2 and 3. Okay, so you have to answer because they are the co-prime co-prime factors of the number. Okay, now let's say a number, friends. Let's say 12. Okay, now now you don't know the divisibility test for 12. Now you are given that is 24 is divisible by 12 or not. Okay, so what you have to do, you have to first check the co-prime factors of 12. Okay, so that will be 4 and 3. Okay, why these are co-prime factors? See, there is a trick also. See, 4 is a composite number and 3 is a prime number, that's right. And if you still you should check the HCF. Okay, if you will check the HCF, you will get. Okay, now see, now you have to check whether 24 is divisible by 4 and 3. Okay, it's divisible by 4. 4, 6 are 24. And it's divisible by 3 also. If we do 2 plus 4, we got 6. Okay, so we can say that 24 is divisible by 12. Bye friends, have a good day, and remember these rules. Don't forget these rules. Bye.